So we've touched on all different parts of the lifecycle now. We've spoke about how definitions touch design, documentation, virtualization, developing the API, and testing the API. Of course, there's also monitoring and also deploying the API. That's for a bigger webinar. We're not going to be focusing on those specific phases in this webinar. So I hope in the past 30 minutes or so, we've kind of understood the value of having a definition before you start your development, your testing, your deployment, and your virtualization, right? So that we call that approach the design first approach, where you're building out a brand new API and you're starting from the definition first before you do any of these other phases. You're designing that API first. But what happens when you have all these existing legacy APIs which don't have a specification in place? You know, you have so many old APIs, RESTful APIs, which don't have a standard already defined. So that we call as the code-first approach, where you have the existing application's code API's code base, and now you need to start thinking about how to generate the definition so that moving forward, you can just update that. You can focus on a definition-driven approach in that specific scenario. So for that process, we actually also have a tool called Swagger Inspector that allows you to generate the OpenAPI definition from the existing API. Swagger Inspector is completely free. So again, this kind of ties into Swagger's policy of open source as well as free tools, as well as some commercial tools, but primarily we wanna make sure that our community gets the best out of all the things that we have to offer. So it's an easy to use online cloud-based tool to validate an API. Also, while you're validating, generating a corresponding OpenAPI definition. So you can actually, on the cloud itself, you can actually generate the OpenAPI documentation or your definition from existing APIs which don't have a definition in place. Right, so the core value, of course, is to not just ensure that the API's work is intended, because again, you're validating the API, but you're also simultaneously generating the definition, which in turn leads to user-friendly documentation. So we've spoken about the OpenAPI, which is the specification, right? So that's the specification, that's the definition that essentially defines what your API does, which leads to all this, which leads to the acceleration of different parts of your lifecycle. Swagger is the set of tools, right? Swagger was a market leader in the RESTful world when it created the Swagger specification. We donated it to the OpenAPI initiative just so that, and renamed it as the OpenAPI specification so we could standardize this across the world. And now Swagger is a broad sort of tools. We have a broad suite of tools all the way from open source tools like Swagger UI and Editor, going to free tools like Swagger Inspector, and to commercial tools like Swagger Hub. So we want to cater to a broader set of audiences and make sure that we can help you as best as we can to accelerate your API development.